Hi there and welcome back. Let's review tremor today. We'll look into the meaning, types, classifications from a different perspective, causes, treatment, and how do we underwrite. A tremor is an unintentional and uncontrollable rhythmic movement of one part or one limb of your body. A tremor can occur in any part of the body and at any time. It is usually the result of a problem in the part of your brain that controls muscular movement. Tremors are not always serious, but in some cases they may indicate a serious disorder. Most tremors cannot be treated easily, but they will often go away on their own. It is important to note that muscle spasms, muscle twitches, and tremors are not the same thing. A muscle spasm is the involuntary contraction of a muscle. A muscle twitch is an uncontrolled fine movement of a small portion of a larger muscle. This twitch may be visible under the skin. What are the types? Tremors are divided into two types, resting and action. Resting tremors occur when you are sitting or lying still. Once you begin to move around, you will notice that the tremor goes away. Resting tremors often affect only the hands or fingers. Action tremors occur during movement of the affected body part. Action tremors are further divided into subcategories. An intention tremor occurs during targeted movement, such as touching your finger to your nose. Kinetic tremors occur during movement of a body part, such as moving your wrist up and down. You may also see a postural tremor that occurs when holding a position against gravity, such as holding your arm or leg outstretched. Then another kind is isometric tremors that may occur during the voluntary contraction of a muscle without other movement of the muscle. And there is one more type known as task-specific tremors occur during a specific activity such as writing. In addition to these types, tremors are also classified by their appearance and cause. So the most common you will see in the medical records is essential tremor. Essential tremor is the most common type of movement disorder. Essential tremors are usually postural or intention tremors. An essential tremor may be mild and not progress, or it may slowly progress. If the essential tremor progresses, it often starts on one side and then affects both sides within a few years. Essential tremors weren't thought to be associated with any disease processes. However, recent studies have connected them to mild degeneration in the cerebellum, which is the part of the brain that controls motor movement. Essential tremors are sometimes associated with mild walking difficulty and hearing disability, and they tend to run in families. Another classification is that you may come across while reading the medical records is called physiologic tremor, and that is often caused by a reaction to certain drugs, alcohol withdrawal, or medical conditions such as hypoglycemia or low blood sugar, or an overactive thyroid gland. Physiologic Tremor usually goes away if you eliminate the cause. One more classification is called a Parkinsonian tremor, and that is usually a resting tremor and is often the first sign of Parkinson's disease. It is caused by damage to parts of the brain that control movement. The onset is usually after age 60. It begins in one limb or on one side of the body, and then it progresses to the other side. Then another classification is called orthostatic tremor. It usually occurs in the legs. This is a rapid rhythmic muscle contraction that occurs immediately after you stand. This tremor is often perceived as unsteadiness. There are no other clinical signs or symptoms. The unsteadiness stops when you sit, are lifted, or when you start walking. Another type or classification is a dystonic tremor, and that occurs irregularly. Complete rest can relieve these tremors. This tremor occurs in people who have dystonia, which is a movement disorder characterized by involuntary muscle contractions. The muscle contractions cause twisting and repetitive motions or abnormal postures such as twisting of the neck. These can occur at any age. Another classification known as a psychogenic tremor may present as any of the tremor types. It is characterized by sudden onset and remission, changes in the direction of your tremor and the affected body part, and greatly decreased activity when you are distracted. Patients with psychogenic tremors often have conversion disorder, that is a psychological condition that produces physical symptoms, or another psychiatric disease. One more classification is called cerebellar tremor. The cerebellum is the part of the hind brain that controls movement and balance. A cerebellar tremor is a type of intention tremor caused by lesions or damage to the cerebellum from a stroke, tumor, or disease such as multiple sclerosis. It may also be the result of a chronic alcoholism or overuse of certain medications. So, what are the causes? Prescription medications, diseases, injuries, stress, and caffeine can all cause tremors. The most common causes of tremors are stress, aging, muscle fatigue, low blood sugar levels, and ingesting too much caffeine. Medical conditions that can cause tremors include Parkinson's disease, multiple sclerosis, stroke, traumatic brain injury, hyperthyroidism, and alcoholism. So, how do we treat tremor? If you get treatment for the underlying condition causing the tremor, that treatment may be enough to cure the tremor. Treatments for the tremor include medications, Botox injections, physical therapy, and those with debilitating tremors may end up with brain stimulation surgery. So, how do we underwrite? Look for the type of tremor, underlying cause, if any, and follow your company's underwriting manual and the company specifics. So, with that, let's take a break here and see you soon. Take care. Bye now.